Now, earlier this month, we brought you the story of coral turning white in oceans all over the world. It's known as coral bleaching and happens because of rising sea temperatures. And one of the causes is climate change. A BBC wildlife documentary called Our Changing Planet has been looking at the effects this has been having on coral and meeting the people who are trying to help. Nina spoke to one of the show's presenters, Liz Bonnin, to find out more.
Hey Liz, thank you so much for joining us on Newsround. First off, can you just explain what is coral and why is it so important to us?
Corals are extraordinary little animals. We don't often think of them as animals. We think of these amazing multicoloured reefs and with this sort of hard exoskeleton, this hard structure. But actually, corals are little polyps, little... They almost look like little jellyfish, minuscule jellyfish, that live in huge colonies. And they're some of the most extraordinary animals I've ever had the pleasure to learn about. When people ask me what my favourite animal is, I often say coral, and they're a bit surprised. But it's because they're capable of building things so much bigger and vaster than themselves. They also live in symbiosis, so in a kind of a mutually beneficial relationship with these little algae that live in their tissues. And the algae use the light to produce energy for the coral animals to survive. And in return, the corals give the algae safety. The biggest threat to corals is climate change, warming oceans. When the oceans get too hot, the corals get stressed and they release those little algae that they rely on to get their energy from, and they can recover them if the oceans cool again. But more and more we're seeing the oceans are staying warm for far too long, so it makes the corals stressed for too long, and then eventually they die and they starve.
And as part of that episode, you go out and you meet people who are doing their best to help coral. What are they doing to help?
So basically, we feature all sorts of different scientists and different individuals who have come together and collaborated with others to find really novel, new, exciting solutions to the coral crisis.
Do you think all this effort is going to help?
There's no question that all of these projects are giving corals a lifeline. Without them, I don't think corals would have any chance of surviving, and that's quite a big statement to make, but the truth is we've lost over 50% of our coral reefs around the world, and we stand to lose all of them in the next 20 or 30 years. So what each of these amazing individuals, and by the way, there are more, we feature some scientists in Florida, and you know, there's lots of people doing amazing things, you know, without them, I don't think I'd be as positive about the future of coral reefs.
Oh, lovely to hear from Liz. And to know more, the special episode of Our Changing Planet about coral is available on the BBC iPlayer.